Novelty Health Shine.
Hello, I'm Dr. Aradhya Yechuri, fertility consultant at Medix Fertility Clinic, Hyderabad. I would like to wish all of you on this World IVF Day, which is on July 25th. This is the day when the world's first IVF baby, Louis Brown, was born in England in 1978. Over these 43 years, more than 8 million babies have been born all over the world through different ART procedures. Even though one in every six couples in India face the problem of infertility, there is still a lot of taboo about it. Because of this, many couples do not want to come out and tell that they're actually facing this issue. This creates a lot of delay in the identification of the problem and the treatment as well. Many people have this misconception that for infertility, the only solution is IVF. But there are many other simple treatments which can solve their issue when we identify the exact problem. So when do you need to see a fertility specialist? If your age is less than 35 and you have been having regular unprotected intercourse over the past 1 year and are still not able to conceive, you should definitely see a doctor. If your age is more than 35, you should not wait beyond 6 months to get help. If you have irregular periods or if you are facing issue in having intercourse, you should definitely see a doctor. Transvaginal ultrasound for a woman and semen analysis for a man are the most basic tests which are required to diagnose the problem. Other than this, there are other tests, hormonal tests like thyroid problems and prolactin, which can also help to identify the problem. If everything is normal, then the next step would be to go for ovulation induction. In this procedure, the tablets are given to make the follicles grow. Ultrasound is done to track the growth of these follicles. By doing this, we can exactly determine the proper timing of ovulation. Then the couple is advised to have intercourse. The next step after this, if they fail to achieve pregnancy after 3 or 4 cycles of ovulation induction, there is another procedure called as intrauterine insemination. In this procedure, we take the husband's sample, wash it and select the most motile sperms and introduce them directly into the uterine cavity using a small catheter. This increases the number of sperms which are available in the uterine cavity close to the tubes. So we are bypassing the distance the sperms have to travel to reach the eggs. This can increase the success rate by 15 to 20%. Another important test which has to be done to check the tubal patency is a hysterosalpingogram or a sonosalpingogram. By doing this test, we can check if the tubes are open or not. Because if there is any issue with the tube, no matter how many times they try, the sperm and egg cannot meet, so they cannot get pregnant. Apart from ovulation and intrauterine insemination, some people may need to go for surgical procedures like laparoscopy or hysteroscopy to treat any small minor problems. These are not major procedures and will not cause lot of discomfort. They are daycare procedures and the patient can be sent home in the same day. By doing these measures, 80 to 90% of the couples will conceive. However, 10 to 20% of couples still need higher treatment, which is called as in vitro fertilization or ICSI, that is the test tube baby. In this, the patient is given injections for 8 to 10 days to make the follicles grow. Once the follicles are good enough in size, they are taken to the operation theater and they are given short general anesthesia. This is a minor procedure which is done over 20 to 30 minutes. The patient can go home in 4 hours. There are no stitches in this procedure. A thin needle is passed from the vagina into the ovary and the follicular fluid is aspirated. The husband has to give sample on the same day. The sperms are directly injected into the egg. This is called as intracytoplasmic sperm injection. Then the embryos which are formed are directly introduced into the uterine cavity by passing a small catheter. This is called as embryo transfer. This is also a very simple procedure and does not require any kind of anesthesia. Once embryo transfer is done, the results will be known in 14 days. The success rate of a single attempt of IVF is 45 to 50%. It means if 10 couples are undergoing this procedure in a month, 4 to 5 people will conceive in the very first attempt. If they have a lot of embryos, the rest of the embryos are frozen, and if the first cycle fails, the frozen embryos can be transferred in the subsequent month. They don't have to go through the entire procedure all over again. Tablets are given, 2 to 3 scans are done, and then embryo transfer procedure is repeated. There are no health issues to the mother or the baby by going through an IVF procedure. More than 8 million babies have been born so far, and none of them had any congenital conditions. So it is a safe procedure for both the mother and the baby. So if you are facing any issues while conceiving, it is ideal to meet a fertility consultant and get your problems checked. The faster you get your treatment, the better would be the success rate. As the age increases, the success rate also comes down. So please take care and get help if needed.
If you know of any couple who are unable to conceive within 12 months of trying, please encourage them to seek help from medical experts. Let the reach of scientific advances in reproductive health spread to all corners of the country and bring joy to all such couples. This public awareness message aimed at spreading awareness on infertility and its treatment is brought to you by Novelty Health Shine.